Friendship, family, and fun. What do these words have in common? They're integral parts of the human experience and also share the same first letter. Our ancestors thousands of years in the past may have struggled to pronounce these words, as the f sound would have been cumbersome to produce. Sounds like f or v are called labiodentals. Labio, relating to your lips, and dentals, your teeth. They are produced when you raise your bottom lip to touch your upper teeth. Labiodentals are used in over half of the languages spoken around the world today, but before shifts in food processing technology, these sounds may not have been as common. Before the Neolithic, food was minimally processed and required more effort to chew. This constant gnashing meant teeth wore down more, resulting in what is known as an edge-to-edge bite by adolescents. Then came the emergence of food processing technologies. Gone were the days of laborious chewing, as stews, preserved foods, and ground grain as flour became more common. Softer food meant less wear and tear on the teeth, and the preservation of an overbite, a vertical overlap of the teeth, and an overjet, horizontal overlapping of the teeth, which humans are normally born with. Researchers created a biomechanical model of an edge-to-edge bite, aligned top and bottom teeth, and an overjet and overbite to see if one provided an advantage for articulating labiodentals. They found that the edge-to-edge configuration would have required more effort to produce a labiodental, as the distance from the bottom lip and top teeth would have been greater. The preservation of an overbite and overjet also increased the likelihood that a labiodental would be made on accident, like saying f instead of p. Today, nearly all societies have access to softer foods, and most people retain their overbite and overjet throughout their lifetimes. This makes producing labiodentals easier, but historically, not all languages have had these sounds. Nowadays, many languages are acquiring labiodental sounds like f and v through contact with other languages that have them. One example includes West Greenlandic speakers, who have been in long-sustained contact with European languages, including Danish. This study shows how language can be shaped by changes in human biology. In the future, researchers hope to better understand not only how this language change took place, but why. Some data suggests that labiodentals served as an indicator of social class, proving advantageous to those who adopted the sound. In the meantime, thank your local food processor for being able to say those F words.